Okay, in this particular video, I'm going to quickly show you how to do a table of offsets. And what we're going to start with first is doing a Cartesian plane. The Cartesian plane, when you're doing tables of offsets, the x-axis we refer to as the butt line, and the vertical line, or the y-axis, is the water lines. It's also oftentimes very helpful if, when as you're drawing up your plans, actually draw yourself a little Cartesian grid. Tables of offsets that I'm familiar with out of canoe craft talk about spacing of 2 inches. So I literally, on whatever piece of paper, plastic, or however you're going to be constructing these, I literally draw lines every 2 inches. Draw horizontal lines every 2 inches and vertical lines every 2 inches. Now I'm only going in extreme detail here on the right-hand side, which is where your bow stems are going to be drawn. The left-hand side, where I don't have any vertical lines listed, is where the stern segments are going to be drawn. For our purposes here, though, I'm just going to quickly sketch this up, and I'm going to show you how to do this. All right, so I'm looking at, on page 56 in Canoe Craft, the table of offsets for the Freedom canoe model, and I'm going to loft, let's do station number 3. I'm going to do that on the right-hand side, and what I'm looking at first is the shear line has is listed as 0 feet, 4 inches, and 3/8 plus a 16th. So in other words, not quite 4.5 inches. So the shear line is going to be our center vertical axis that's listed there, the big thick black line that you see. And let's see, that's going to be just over 4, not quite 4.5 inches. So I'm going to switch colors here. We'll do our points in purple. And I'm going to come up and create a point at about 4.5 inches. Okay, then the next one down for the 2-inch butt, that's going to be the first line to the right of our origin. And I've got 1 foot, 7 inches. So a total of 19 inches. So what I'm looking at is coming over to here, and I'm going to go up. I'm going to go up 19 inches. So I count up 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. And I put a mark right here. Okay. So that's going to be our first set of coordinates. The next one is for the 4-inch butt, and that is listed as 1 foot, 6 inches, and 3/8. So I need to, at the second line, vertical line to the right of the origin, go up 18 inches and 3/8. So again, I'm going to go, let's see. I'm going to be working on this vertical line, and I'm going to go up 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 18 inches and 3/8. So I'm looking at something kind of like this. Of course, this is not drawn to scale, so it might look a little funky. I'll try to be as reasonably accurate as I can. Next one down would be the 6-inch butt line. It has a reference number of 1 foot, 5 inches, and 2 plus eighths. So 17 inches and 2 plus eighths. So we're talking just a hair over 17 and a quarter inches. As I measure these on paper, I would actually be fairly accurate here. So I'm going to be doing the 6-inch, 6-inch butt mark, and I'm going to go up again that just over 17 and a quarter inches. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17 and a quarter inches, be somewhere in there. And then the last one is at the 8-inch butt line, and that number listed is 1 foot, 2 inches, and 6 plus eighths. So we're looking at 14 and just over 3 quarters inches. 14 and 3 quarters inches. So I'm going to be doing this vertical line, and I'm going to go up 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and say 3 quarters inches. So not quite halfway in between those two lines. Now you can see there's some sort of a curve that's starting to develop. Now in the table of heights, our numbers have actually run out at this point. So now what we're going to do, I'm going to look at the numbers that are listed on the table of half breadths for station number 3. All right, so now we're actually switching the way we do this here. So let's take a look at, for station number 3, the shear line is given as 8 inches and 6 eighths. 8 inches and 6 eighths. So I'm going to be looking at the horizontal line, and I want to make a mark at 8 inches and 6 eighths. So 2, 4, 6, 8, and I'm going to change color here just to keep the two distinct from each other. 8 inches, not quite 9 inches. So we're looking at something along there. Then as I go down, I don't have a water line at 2 inches, and I don't have one at 4 inches, because the shear line actually, once you connect the dots for the shear lines for all the stations, your shear line is actually going to give you your gunnel line. It's going to show you where the top edge of your canoe is. So I shouldn't have anything that exists on those horizontal lines, the water line, for the waterline marks for 2 and 4 inches. But for station number 3, for the 6-inch waterline, I do want to place a mark at 8 inches and 6 eighths. So what I'm looking at now, instead of doing going out along the butt line first, I'm going to, because the water lines are listed here, at the 6-inch waterline, so I come up 2, 4, at the 6-inch waterline right there, I need to go over 8 inches and 6 eighths. So 2, 4, 6, 8 inches and 6 eighths. We're talking not quite 9 inches, somewhere about there. The next water line, which is going to be up here, the 8-inch water line is right there. I need to come out 8 inches and 5 plus 8. So it actually comes in ever so slightly at the next water line. Again, the next water line down then, I'm looking at the 10-inch one. So I go 2, 4, 6, 8. At the 10-inch water line, I'm going to go horizontally out 8 inches and 5 eighths. So 2, 4, 6, 8 inches and 5 eighths. So if you're actually able to reference these in the Canoe Craft book, you're going to notice that the difference between the 6-inch water line, 8-inch water line, and the 10-inch water line, those are actually decreasing by only a 16th of an inch at a time at this particular point. So the 12-inch water line then, we're going to go 8 inches and 4 eighths, so 8 and a half inches. So I'm up here, and I'm going to go out 2, 4, 6, 8, and we're going to be somewhere about there. Next one, next horizontal line up for the 14-inch water line is 8 inches and just over an eighth, so approximately there. As you see these dots line up now, you can see that you definitely have something. If we connect the dots at this point, we're going to have some kind of a curve that's going to resemble half of a cross-section of a canoe. I've got a couple more waterline points to draw here. The 16-inch one, I need to go out 7 inches and 3 eighths. So for, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. I need to go 7 inches and 3 eighths. So 2, 4, 6, 7, and 3 eighths. So I'm maybe about there. And then the last one listed, I go over for the 18-inch water line, which is going to be this horizontal line right here. I'm going to go over 4 inches and just over 6 eighths, so just over 4 and 3 quarters inches. So go over 2, 4, and about 3 quarters inches right there. After you've done this, what you can do is, I'm going to do these in brown. We just play connect the dots. So I'm roughly going to connect these dots here. And this is going to give me the basic outline of station number 3. Now the other stations, as you draw this, like if I would draw station number 2, depending on how much rocker there is in the boat, might look something like this. Station number 1, then, as you're getting closer and closer to the bow, might be something like this. These particular plans in Canoe Craft have a station 0, and that might actually look something like this. Okay, so it would make sense that as you do these, if we're starting with the narrowest one as station 0, that's at toward the front of the canoe, it would only hopefully make sense to you that this 0 station is going to be the narrowest station on the front half of the boat, and progressively as we increase in numbers out to probably number 6, 7, or 8, depending on which canoe you're working on, they'll steadily get wider. And the next one might look something like this, and then something like this. And at some point here, you're going to be able to take the markings for the shear line, and you're going to be able to create something. You're going to be able to draw something on here that's going to connect all your all the highest points on your canoe stations like that. So you're going to be able to know exactly where the top edge of your canoe is. Of course, these stations are actually lofted upside down because that's how you actually build your canoe. You're building it upside down. After you've lofted all your bow stations, then, and you'll notice your bow stations because in your table of offsets, in your table of heights, you'll notice it forms kind of an upside-down pyramid, and I just divide the list in half. So this particular canoe has stations from 0 to 16, so there's actually a total of 17 stations there, which means there's 8 bow stations, 8 stern stations, and then one center station. The center station, and it really doesn't matter if you do like I would do on this particular boat, possibly the first 8 stations on the right-hand side and then the remaining stations on the left-hand side. Really just a matter of can you actually physically draw all the stations on one side. If you find that two of them are lofted too close together, flip it over, put it on the other side. Well, I hope this has been helpful to you guys. Lofting stations, it's not too terrible. Once you get the hang of it, just remember that the butt line actually forms your x-axis, the water line forms your y-axis. Make sure all your points kind of line up, make sure they make sense visually so that it actually starts to look like a canoe. In the meantime, have yourself a great night. Hope this has been a bit of help to you.